I'm back. I'm here. Hey friends, it's Tay. I am, this video I filmed the other day, but I lost the opening footage. I still have everything explaining what I'm talking about, and stuff like that, but I just wanted to basically pop in and say hi. I just didn't want to start it without anything in front of it. So, interesting topic today. I had a fun time doing this. I hope you guys liked our new animated intro. It is so cute. It was made by my friend Chocolito.png, but they did an absolutely amazing job and I think it looks adorable, and they used Sweet Pea for it and they were just amazing. They made it so much better than I originally wanted it. I basically came to them and I was like, I would like an animated intro of Sweet Pea. They delivered and it was absolutely amazing, so if you would like to go give them some love or get a commission done by them, please go and check them out. They are awesome. Really timely also, like they did it super quick, and I know it's just a few seconds, but animation is hard. I hope that you enjoy the rest of our video. We're gonna do some time traveling right now. So what I'm trying to get at is TikTok is not a good platform for educating about animals. And right now, frogs are a trending pet. Listen, I would be the biggest liar in the world if I tried to come on here and say that I did not benefit from this trend at all. I definitely do and have benefited from the frog craze, but there are some issues with this craze, and that is the fact that it is a trend. Let me just explain this a little bit more, okay? So one major problem with this is that everybody and their grandma wants a frog. Unfortunately, what that means is that people are going to go to pet stores without doing any research beforehand, walk in there and say, I would like to buy a frog. I know that there are some people who will do the research and genuinely want to learn and take good care of their frogs, obviously. But that is not everybody interested in getting a little green buddy. Another issue with this is that there is tons of misinformation out there, given via pet stores, the internet. I mean, I've read article upon article of just crap. A lot of it is out of date and, you know, written by pet blogs that don't focus on frogs. They throw frogs in there for a blog post. And so they don't do the proper research. And there's so much just floating around on the internet. It seems very logical. And I could understand that for a beginner, how that would seem logical, because I have been there. There is so much contradicting info out there too. It's hard to know what is right, what is wrong, what is real, what is not, especially around substrates and handling. A lot of stuff is out of date and people have found better ways to do these things, or more correct ways to do these things, and people are just getting their information from older blogs and just reposting it. On top of all the info from websites, we now have large influencers who are not in the animal community, which you don't have to be in the animal community to get a certain animal, but they're giving out information like they are a part of that community or like they've had a frog for so many years, and a lot of it is just incorrect, or they don't even put information out there at all, and they're just throwing it out there on the internet, doing things that you really shouldn't, and that could harm your frog. Another problem with this is large influencers can so easily influence younger audiences. I mean, some of the stuff I've seen going around on TikTok that kids have found to be true, to an adult, it seems insane that anyone would ever believe it. Kids are a little bit stupid, if I'm being honest. And they'll believe a lot of stuff that's just put out there. It's super easy to influence a younger audience. I mean, people do it all the time. I could name 30 influencers right now, but I'm not going to. Since I'm only one person, I can't go around and correct every single care sheet. What I'm gonna do today is just give y'all some basics and use this list to decide whether or not a frog is the correct pet for you. Slash, are you the correct owner for the frog? I'm gonna be as general as I can, but obviously every species is different and they all require different things. So, yeah, just keep that in mind. But just know that everything I'm going to say here is generally correct for white's tree frogs, unless I say otherwise. That's the main one people come to me about, so that's the main one we're gonna be talking about today. So the first thing that we need to talk about is expenses. Obviously, when a parent is going to look into whether or not their child or their family in general should get a pet, it is going to be how much that pet costs, including all of the care items that they need, weekly, yearly, monthly expenses. The initial cost for a frog and all of the things they need is going to be about $200. Obviously, that's going to vary depending on where you buy everything. But generally, I would say that you're probably going to spend around $200. Most frogs need about 20 gallons to start off. You know, it depends on the species. For white's tree frogs, that's going to be either a 12 by 12 by 18, or if you want to start big with two frogs, you can use an 18 by 18 by 24. A regular 20 gallon is probably going to be what you need to start with for burrowing frogs, but obviously there are certain ones who do better in smaller spaces like Pac-Man frogs, so you may want to start with a 5 to 10 gallon depending on the size of them. Two adult white's tree frogs can live a very happy life in an 18 by 18 by 24 tank. A white's tree frog cannot spend its whole life in a 12 by 12 by 18. That is way too small. White's tree frogs, especially the females, get very large, about the size of your palm. They simply cannot live in that small of a tank. They need room to explore. Even if you're taking them out every day for some exercise and stimulation and exploring, it doesn't matter. An adult frog needs a bigger size than a 12 by 12 by 18, whether you just go straight to the 18 by 18 by 24 or a taller tank in between. You know, whatever you find that fits, but they cannot spend their life in that small of a tank. As for substrates, depending on if you're getting Ego Earth, using paper towels, or using a substrate like frog foam, that will all depend and vary on price depending on where you're getting it from. I personally prefer frog foam over paper towels, because frog foam is a lot easier to clean, it's a lot easier to monitor how much moisture you're putting in there, and it can't be ingested. Trigger warning, I'm gonna put some photos here, so just skip 10 seconds and it'll be over with. Paper towel can often be ingested and then impact the frog, getting caught in their bum or their mouth, or God forbid, inside of them in their intestines, and they're unable to pass it. It can end in death. I try not to use paper towel unless it's for sick frogs. You will also need lighting fixtures, so you're gonna need a basic daytime bulb. Typically a 50 to 75 watt daytime heat lamp will do for an 18 by 18 by 12. You might need to go a little bit smaller or less wattage on a smaller tank and a little bit more on a bigger tank. You cannot use any colored lights, so no red, no blue, green. It can cause eye problems as they grow up. You cannot use a heat mat for tree frogs. I don't even like them for burrowing frogs because even with a thermostat, they tend to overheat and they can burn feet. And if you have not been listening for the rest of these items, please listen to this item. Frogs need UVB. Certain toad species and Pac-Mans are typically fine without UVB, especially if they are more sensitive and albino species. But if you are having tree frogs, please use UVB and do not get a coil bulb. They don't really work. A lot of coil bulbs that say they're UVB are just kind of a white light. They're not actually UVB. You're just not gonna get the same quality of UVB that you would from a tube lighting. So one like this is absolutely perfect, other than a coil bulb, and that's what a coil bulb looks like. They're yucky. Get out of here. On top of this, you're gonna need vitamins, decor, a spray bottle, dechlorinator for the water, and live food. Their food has to be live. Dried bugs do nothing for nutrition. Your frogs will starve if you're just feeding them dried bugs. You must be okay with having live bugs in your house and feeding them to your frogs. Obviously, you can use tongs so you don't have to touch them with your hands at all, but you're gonna have to be okay with bugs, especially worms and crickets and roaches. Everything together is going to cost a pretty hefty amount for a happy frog, and these things are all required. Please take these into consideration when you're looking at getting a frog. All right, the next thing we've got to discuss is age. Most species of frogs live 10 plus years. A healthy White's tree frog can live 20 plus years in captivity. The oldest White's tree frog is 43 years old, and his name is Fred, and he's adorable. These are not pets that you're gonna take care of 4 or 5 months to a year and then it'll die. Pretty much no pet is like that, other than like bugs, but you know what I mean. This is a commitment over years, just like a dog or a cat would be. If you know you won't be willing to take care of an animal like this for that long, please look the other way. Do not look into frogs. They live for a very long time. This is a huge one, and I cannot stress this enough, because this is, you know, what people see, and they see it and they think, oh my god, I can do this with a frog? Frogs are not toys. Yes, they're extremely cute. I love a hat on a frog, but that is not something they need. It's not something all frogs enjoy. Not every frog is gonna sit there and hang out with you for a little bit and allow you to put a hat on them, no matter how bonded to you they are. Some of them just don't enjoy it, and you know, you have to respect that. Frogs are living animals. I know they're tiny, but they have thoughts and they have feelings. Dressing them up every day and forcing them to do poses they don't want to do, or making them dance or anything like that, it is not okay. Frogs can die from stress, and it is an absolutely horrible way to go. It is one of the most painful ways to go, and it's not fun for you or your child to go through either. Some species of frogs can't be held at all unless you're wearing gloves, and that's no powdered gloves. Plastic gloves are the best. White's tree frogs, toads, pixie frogs, and a couple other species can be held without gloves as long as you have washed hands. You'll want to wash your hands with unscented soap, rinse super, super well, and then when you're going to pick up your frogs, take some of the dechlorinated water that you use to spray down their tanks and spray your hands with it so that you're not getting any tap water or anything like that on them. Make sure you're drying your hands well after as well. The general rule I like to give is 5 to 10 minutes without gloves and washed hands. Anything over that must be with gloves. Anytime you're doing health checks or, you know, checking on certain things with your frog, for your safety and theirs, you should be wearing gloves. While captive tree frogs typically don't have any illnesses that they can pass on, they are very, very dirty babies, meaning that they love to sit in their pee and poo. And you don't want that near your mouth, near your food, or anything like that. For special occasions, it is okay to do photo shoots as long as you're putting them in a safe, clean environment. Frogs absorb things through their skin, so any chemicals, salts, sugars, pretty much any liquid that is going to be on your table or wherever you're doing your photo shoot, they can absorb. They can harm your frog and even cause death. Just make sure you're using common sense and you're also respecting your pet. To use my 12 years of Catholic education, do unto others as you would want done unto yourself. Just respect. That's all the frogs want. Okay. I know that sounded very scary and very negative. If you've stuck around to the end of this video and frogs still sound like a great pet to you, then that's awesome. I don't want y'all to think that frogs are terrible pets, because they are not. They require a lot of work. Yes, that is true, but they are so worth it. If you're younger and you want to get a frog, but you know, your parents keep saying no, or maybe they're just hesitant at certain things, I highly recommend you do a bunch of research and you make a PowerPoint for them. Often a question I get asked is, how do I convince my parents to let me get a frog? And while some younger people probably shouldn't have frogs, parents are mostly worried that they are going to get stuck with doing everything for the animal. A lot of parents are super busy with work or, you know, just things in their lives, and parents do a lot. I know, I know you might be sitting there as a young person saying, I don't know about that, but trust me, I am now 20 years old. You'll understand it eventually. You know what? Maybe it's not the correct time for a pet. You know, things happen, and that's okay. You can always move out when you're 18 and go buy as many frogs as you want, like I did. But seriously, frogs are amazing animals. And the fact that so many young people are interested in frogs honestly makes me so happy, purely because the world right now is being plagued with mass extinction of species of frogs and other amphibians because of chytrid and habitat loss. The fact that there is a mass amount of Gen Z kids who are in love with frogs is a great thing. If you want a frog, but you don't think that you or your parents personally could take care of it, there are other ways that you can help frogs and make the world a better place for froggies. Donating to organizations like Save the Frogs, I'll put a link down below, savethefrogs.com. Absolutely love them, they're doing amazing things for chytrid research. Or any other environmental cause, especially organizations dealing with habitat loss are awesome. Planting trees, cleaning up litter, signing petitions to end deforestation, and just informing others are all ways that we can ensure that wild frogs get to be on this planet for a very, very long time. On that note, thank you all for listening. I hope this was a little insightful, and I really hope this helped you on your journey to decide whether or not you want to get a frog. If you have any extra questions or want to learn more, I highly recommend you go and check out Josh's Frogs Care Sheet website. Their blogs are absolutely awesome, as well as join my friend's Facebook group. It's pretty cool. A plug for her, she's awesome. But it is drama-free White Street Frogs group. Not gonna say why it's drama-free. If you know, you know. If you don't worry about it. There's tons of info there. I'm constantly in comments and things and posting and helping other people. So that's kind of the best way to find information really quick or get help with something really quick. I've also got an FAQs highlight on my Instagram that has a bunch of information. It does need to be updated. I know it's not looking the best right now. I think my thing just fell and now I've got a bald spot. Interesting. And then I also have a references highlight there with a lot of really cool posts made by some awesome people, and you can go and check those out. They're very informative. You can also join my Discord. I need to be more active in it. I apologize for anyone who's coming from my Discord. I love you. I'm sorry. But I am in there every once in a while, and there are also a bunch of amazing people who can help you out there. My DMs are currently closed just because it was a little bit overwhelming, and a lot of them were the same questions and things that I could send people to my FAQs, but I felt really, really bad, and it was getting on me that I wasn't getting to all these requests, so other creators recommended that I turn them off. If you want to contact me though, you can go to my Instagram, and the little email button there has my email attached to it, so you can email it to that. Any of the links in my Beacon bio are also great. That'll take you to multiple social media platforms, to my YouTube channel. Our Discord server is in there. And that is really it for it today, guys. I enjoyed making this and I enjoyed talking to you, and I hope you learned something today. Orby was our little helper today. He was in here. I don't know if you saw him. But yeah, I hope this helped a little bit. If there's anything to take away from this, don't believe everything you see on TikTok, please. And do your research. Please, do your research. Super important. That's literally all I ask of you. People make me really, really proud when they do research. So if you want to make your internet mom proud, do your research. Clean up your room. I don't know. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Whenever that is. I don't know. It may be in a year from now, but we'll see. Bye, y'all. Mwah. I love you. I care for you. You are valid, you are beautiful, and yeah, go out there and have a good day, or night, you know, whatever time you see this, and mwah, I will see you next time. Goodbye.